First off, I gotta say, I am super excited to welcome all my pals back to the annual Blackwood Winter Getaway. Let's make this one trip we will never forget.
All right, we are still at E3, still in the PlayStation Lounge. We're taking a look at Until Dawn, and I'm here with one of the creators. Can you explain to the viewers out there what is it you're showing here that's new?
So this is a new chapter. We didn't want to show too much, obviously, because it's a big part of the story. It's about midway through. It's actually, we can't always know exactly what the beginning is going to be. So depending on what happened beforehand, we have a little previously on film because we don't know what the decisions have been made. But this follows a pair of the friends up on the mountain. Again, I don't want to say too much about the story. It's really funny. I don't want to, you know, give too much away. But it's very, very different. It's much more about the choices. There are some significant choices in this that will end badly if chosen wrongly.
Yeah, how is that demoing and showing to people for you guys? Because you don't want to you want to show people what the game is about and give them a feel, but you don't want to spoil it. People should have that experience when they play the game.
Yeah, I mean the good thing is that whatever people are playing today might and certainly won't be the same for everybody else. So it's, you know, it is a spoiler if you kind of, you know, if you get to this bit and you do exactly the same thing every single time. But that's the way it works. It's the choices and the informed nature of those choices that will change it for you.
What was the idea behind this? How do you came to do a game like this?
Well, I mean, the original one was for the PS3. Do you remember, like, 4 years ago, and it was a move control game, and we started working on that. And in those days, it was a little less kind of mature. It was kind of a bit more teen horror. We got to the end of Gamescom, and there was this massive kind of demand for people saying we want it for the PlayStation 6 Access as well. It doesn't want to just be moved. And at that time, Sony were going, okay, well, we've got PS4 coming down the line. Why don't we do the whole thing for that? So we kind of changed it around. We rewrote it, much more mature, much more like a kind of a horror thing. We changed it to a cinematic display, you know, like every single shot is has been done by a director of photography. We've done it with a new cast, a prominent cast, and literally just gone and changed the engine that we were using to the next version of the engine. We've changed the lighting styles, just pushed everything up a notch. So that's how the whole thing started, and then it just took off. The choice mechanic that we go, I mean, the game is basically about choices. All the way through, you get choices, tiny little choices or big choices. It's hard to always know whether or not there's going to be an impact. But those choices change absolutely the story that you're going to play. There's certain bits where there are very, very big choices that will have a knock-on. We call that the butterfly effect. So the butterfly effect will come up. You'll see it come up, you know, and you'll go, oh, right, I've now affected something significant now. Those choices are informed by things you find around the world. The more you explore, the more clues you'll find, the more informed you'll be about your choices. So that's kind of how it all works out.
So when I got to try it, you do different things, you get different choices, and you sort of do a thing where you try to hint to people that things could happen, but that must be a really hard thing to balance for you guys, because you don't want to make it too obvious, but you also want to give people the feeling that they have a chance to see the hint.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, it always is a balance. It's really interesting watching people play, because we expect, you know, in fact, everyone expects that people will behave the way they behave. And we just see it completely different. People always make different choices to the ones that you'd expect. We're not overly worried about giving too much away in tests. And we tested it really thoroughly. There's a definite kind of balance where that works out. But also, we want to be able to give you ideas of a potential future. So we kind of, you know, we can give you an idea that this might happen. It's open. It's going to, you know, if you do certain things, it's going to happen. But it might not. So you're able to, you know, alter and change the course of stuff still.
Are you worried about people, you know, regretting their decision and then trying to go to an old save or things like that?
We kind of stopped that happening. The way that it comes up, you've got to go to your last point. There is no wrong decision. So we want to make sure that even if you went, oh, God, I didn't want to do that, And I'll tell you another reason why. We don't want people to go back and change it and change it and change it and change it, because actually that might be a decision that has a big knock-on that's a much better decision. So you don't know. So, you know, what looks bad at the first might be brilliant, might be the best thing ever. But if you keep going back and trying to get the perfect short-term answer, that would be a real... you'd lose out. You'd really lose out on that.
Yeah, because like the choices seems very, you know, black and white sometimes, or like it's two options, but it's not a very, you know, it's a very open game in a way as well.
Yeah. And also we try to make these choices sometimes two horrible choices. It's like there's a bad choice and there's another bad choice. So we don't want to, it's not like, okay, if you do that, that's obviously going to be good. We've got moral choices as well, and we try not to be moralistic about it, but we, you know, there are, the morals are your own morals, whatever you want to do. You know, do you save the girl? Do you go for your own safety, or do you shoot somebody? Or, you know, there's a whole bunch of choices in there, but they're your choices. And they're not really, there are no right or wrong choices. Regardless of how you get to the end of this game, you'll get to the end of this game. So, you know, sometimes there'll be everybody dead. Sometimes everyone will be alive. There'll be versions of half, you know, the permutations are massive. And there isn't a wrong one. I mean, I imagine most people are going to want to play it and keep everyone alive. But it doesn't matter if you don't. You know, it's a horror film. So it's like, you know, that's, you expect people to die.
And I guess you see people liking different characters depending on how they do choices as well? Or
it's definitely, we've got this character update thing. We were very aware that, and this is true about all sort of interactive drama stuff. We're very aware that the person who plays this game is going to be aware of one path. The path they took, you know, even though there are hundreds of other versions. And the same goes for character arcs. So, you know, you can have a character that goes through this game and comes out really heroic and nice, or he can come out as a complete douche. You know, he can be really, really unpleasant, depending on how you chose to speak, depending on what you chose to do. So we have this thing where we can see the character updates, we call it, just little updates. You can actually go to a screen and find what your character's changed from since the beginning of it. And they all do, and their relationships with each other as well. So, yeah, and it's all down to you.
All right, and finally, when is the game coming out?
I believe August the 25th in the States, 26th, I think, in the UK, I think. It's 25th is definitely in the States, and Friday, I guess, in the UK after.
All right, end of August at least.
Yes.
All right. Have a good E3.
Oh, thank you very much, and you. Cheers.